नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर सत्यश्रीमद्भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज उपस्थित समस्त वैष्णव वैष्णवी चरण कमरों में अंडर द लोटस फीट ऑफ ऑल द वैष्णवीज आई ऑफर माय इनफाइनाइट धन्यवाद प्रणाम श्रीमद् भागवत सुखदेव गोस्वामी पाद सहज महाराज परीक्षित तद्दिनम बुद्धिनम मन्ने What is a bad day in this world? What is a bad day and what is a good day? Carefully, we should try to understand this thing. All the speakers before they spoke very nicely. I was hearing also very nice. They all preach also nicely because this is the instruction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Everybody must preach. In all villages, everywhere my name will be preached. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said this. Mahaprabhu said this. I give this instruction. Everyone preach the glories of the holy names. Okay, so the katha that I was discussing before, what is a good day and what is a bad day? What is a good day? What is a good day according to you? What is a good day according to you? Devotee is saying when we get more money, when we earn money, that is a good day. Good or not? When the business goes well, when the family members, they are happy, buy new things, shopping, we think that's a good day. And a bad day? The day when we when there are clouds in the sky, when it rains and there are thunderstorm, we cannot open our shop, henceforth not earn any money in our wallet, there's no penny at all. That day we consider as a bad day today, no money at all. Not even one penny came today. Not even one penny came. We think that's a bad day. But Sri Sukadev Goswami Pad Maharaj Parikshit. In reality, a bad day is actually the day when we are away from the Bhagavad Katha, which is full of nectar. Achyuta. The day when we are away from the Harikatha, we're not listening, that day is a bad day. But material people won't be able to understand this fact. And a good day we say, the good day when we sit in a sadhu sangha, we listen to Bhagavad Katha, that day is a good day. Carefully you must understand. Money, wealth, wife, family, children, whatever we see in this material world, all this is the coming by the past life karmas. Sometimes coming, sometimes not coming, sometimes destroy also. वाई कर्मास दैट यू हैव डन अकॉर्डिंगली यू विल गेट इवन इफ यू डिजायर मोर यू विल नॉट गेट मोर यू विल ओनली गेट वॉट यू हैव डन कलेक्टेड इन योर पास्ट लाइफ एंड वट एवर यू डू इन दिस लाइफ वट आर यू डूइंग इन दिस लाइफ sins and good karmas virtuous deeds pious activities we bow we plant seeds like this sins and pious activities and the fruits of that is happiness and sadness the fruits they mature and in next life they come back to us understand my point You planted which seed? You planted an acacia tree seed. How will it give mangoes? It's a very very thorny plant. If you plant that and are you expecting mangoes? What will come? Mango will come or not. It depends on the seed. So that's why it is said, as you sow, shall you reap. If we understand, realize this, then happiness, sadness does not affect us at all. It will come depending on the past life karmas actually. What comes after darkness? Light comes after darkness. It's the cycle of nature. This is the law of nature. Like it's always transforming, always changing. But look, what we need to do, we have to give up, not be unaffected by happiness and sadness both. For this we need to do what? We need to do Bhagavata Pachan. Satsang. If you sit in satsang, as ocean of sadhu and you listen to Harikatha, then the jivas, they don't come back to this ocean of material existence. Without satsanga, good knowledge can never come, and without Lord mercy of Lord Ramchandra, we can never get to satsanga. Like these devotees explained, for 1 year, there has been no satsang here at all. Why didn't this happen? Because Ramji did not give mercy. When Ramchandra gives mercy, when God gives mercy, everything is arranged automatically. Understand this carefully. Without satsanga, no possible to have good knowledge, and without Ram mercy, we cannot get sadhusanga. That's why we should go to satsanga. How can we get attain this satsanga? Is it also explained in scriptures? How will we get this? For many many lifetimes, when the spiritual pious activities, when they collect and mature, then we do satsanga, association of sadhu, and by that association of sadhu, then Bhakti Devi manifests in our hearts. And this is what scriptures are teaching us. Conclusion of scripture. People of this material world, they sing music, they do many many things. But look, satsang is said. Wherever real God names are being chanted and discussed, it is satsanga. These days we see some people, they make a film. People are doing film promotion. They just create any script and they are making films. Some ordinary people, materialistic people, but not true. The jivas can never be delivered by that. Understand this thing. The Sant Mahatma, sit in front of Sant Mahatma. Like people trying to learn from documentaries, it's not possible. Then only Sadhu Sangha can help. Only Sadhus can tell directly how to do Sadhu Sangha, how to attain God. All are sadhu, no? No, everyone is not sadhu. The scripture is this definition is given. First, on our forehead, we have to put tilak. In our throat, we have to put tulsi ghanti mala. And in the heart, we need to put Govind. Lalati tilakam nasti. Hey nasti trikandika. Hey nasti Govinda. These days, how is India so bad these days? What has happened? Because we are not following our own culture and tradition properly. Big people, they say that be proud, we are Hindu. This is true, we should be proud. It's true or not? But we must follow the rules. We must eat good food, pure. Ahara shuddhi, chitta shuddhi. Good food pure makes good mind. A good mind remembers to God. If we don't eat pure food, good food, then heart can never be purified. That's why whatever we eat, everything slowly, the food gets break down and it enters our mind. The food enters our mind. That's why in scriptures it is said, Ahara Shuddhi Chitta Shuddhi. Chitta Shuddhi. We can meditate upon God with a good mind. Many people, they say, my mind is disturbed. It's restless. It's like God, not doing it. What is the reason? Properly, you are not eating. You are not taking care of little things properly. Some fault is there. That's why the mind is being disturbed. Some Sant Mahatmas, they say this. You should eat pure food. You should do Bhagavad Bhajan. The monsoon season is almost past, right? The Shravan month, the monsoon month. On every Monday this month, what do? You keep a fast for Lord Shiva, right? On that day, do you eat onion and garlic? Tell me yes or no. Why you don't? And next day you eat. On Tuesday. And the devotee said, after 12 o'clock we eat. What happens after 12 o'clock? The day change? Second day comes. Oh my God. Look. Whatever fast you keep fast every Monday during these months, it's good. It's good to keep a fast. But look, on Monday, we don't. We keep fast and that day we don't eat onion and garlic. Why? What's the reason? On the Monday, why? I asked this question, why not? Why don't you eat onion and garlic? Oh, this devotee does not eat onion and garlic. He does not eat. Achha, who eats? Pick up your hands. Don't be feel shy. Just tell me. Narela is blessed because only one person eats onion garlic here. In Narela, only one person eat onion. No, it's not true. People are hiding. People are hiding. They must be from same family. Those were picking hands up together. Devotees saying at least 50% are eating onion garlic, but they are not picking up their hands. Everybody knows, but they're not speaking. Speak if you speak, if you be truthful. If you eat, just tell, no problem. If you lie, then more sin. Listen, CCTV is here. CCTV coverage here. Yeah, Maharaj color, his name is, what is his name? Chitragupta. If you don't know, Prabhuji knows. What's the name? Chitragupta. Name is like this. Chitragupta. Chitra means he's capturing film, and Gupta means secretly he's capturing everything. You, whether you lie, whatever you do, even Chitragupta knows about what's going on in your mind. That's why his sister was saying, she told that at least 50% people here, they eat onion and garlic. But see, only two people are picking up their hands. So Chitragupta, he's capturing this. I'm saying this, I'm not saying this is bad. Because this is your impression, there could be another reason. For that, I'm not criticizing it. Glorifying or criticizing is not my subject. I just want to know that we keep a fast for Lord Shiva and at day we don't eat onion and garlic. Why? Why not? A demigod, demigoddess, all the demi-devi devis, they all don't eat onion and garlic. Listen this carefully. I'm saying this because in scriptures it is said food must be purified, then he will listen, then Prabhu will listen. If you don't purify the heart food that you are eating, Prabhu will never give you mercy. Translate katha. If you can pray thousands of times, but no possible. I will tell you a little bit of katha. One katha I will tell to you. There was a village. In the village, 2 to 3 years passed by. 3 years passed by and there was no raindrop. It was completely dry. So people of all the village, they abandoned that land and they started to work. But some people, they said, look, we will go to the temple of Thakurji. The temple of Thakurji. And we'll pray to God. We'll pray to God for rain. That time people of all the village, they gathered together and they declared. We will go to Vishnu temple and we'll pray to God Vishnu. Let please rain come. Next day, early in the morning, all the people, they केम
और देखो उसमें एक छोटा बालक था,
देयर वाज अ लिटिल बेबी,
7-8 साल के एक बालक था,
7-8 ईयर ओल्ड बेबी,
अपने बगल में
In his armpit, he came with an umbrella. No one was grabbing an umbrella, but only one little child. He came with an umbrella holding in his arms. After seeing him, all the village people, they started to laugh. Like, oh, see, his little baby is foolish. His mind is also little. 3 years it didn't rain in this village. Why is he roaming around with an umbrella? Everyone was joking on him. They asked the child, tell us, why did you bring this? The child gave a very beautiful answer. He said, I have faith. When all together we prayed to God, then God will listen to us and rain will come 100%. This firm faith he has. Everybody sit down. Where are you going? Don't go now. Sit. It's 2 minutes. It's raining now. You have an umbrella or not? You brought an umbrella? How will you go back home? The little child said, when we all gather together and pray to God, then God will definitely make rain happen. And how will I return back to home? That's why I brought the umbrella. Other villagers said, "Are you are foolish. What are you? 3 years it did not rain and now you are saying it will rain. It is possible. Maybe 2 to 4 days after it will come. Right now it will not come." But the child said, "No. Rain will come. When all we pray to God together, God definitely He listens. Just now in this locality, if anything happens, the municipal corporation, if it's not working, if there's any official of that, I don't know, so don't be offended. Anyways, for example, I'm just giving example. If some municipal officer did not work, did not construct the road, and if there is a road is not proper and the government is not fixing the road, then 2 to 3 people, if you say, no one will listen. But all the people, all the residents of the locality, if they complain, if they go in front of and they protest, then see, the many people protest like this. In televisions you can see, they won't let you go until and unless they fix the road. The protesters are like this. If you speak alone, no one will listen to you. They will say, oh, I'll do tomorrow, later, day after tomorrow. They will face 2 years, 5 years. In 5 years, the person changes locality. So, I'm saying because people of village said, child, you listen. If he will not rain tomorrow, maybe after 6 days, 7 days, rain will come. But the child had the firm faith. No, when we pray together, God will definitely fulfill our desire. Okay. They started to joke. People started to joke. After 10 o'clock, at 10 o'clock sharp, everybody gathered and they started to pray to God. They said, from all the village with same sound with same harmony they were praying to God. Oh Prabhu, you please bring the rain. Simultaneously it started to rain heavily, like cats and dogs. It was raining like cats and dogs. All the people were very very heavy. Prabhuji, today he accepted our prayer. Now rain has come. All our troubles have ended. All the villagers, they became happy. Clap. When the people said, Prabhu, you are so glorious. At that time, an aerial sound came. You foolish villagers. The prayer that you did, I did not listen to your prayers actually. I only heard the prayers of this little child who was grabbing this umbrella. I only heard these prayers. Why? Because he had firm faith. In front of God you can pray. How? With faith you must pray. If you have no faith, then thousands you can say, God will not hear. Just surrender to God. Take shelter of His lotus feet. Say, Prabhu, just give me mercy. Sarang sarnagati hai bijahar. No need to do anything else in the life. Just come in the low shelter of God. Surrender to Lord Ramchandra, surrender to Lord Krishna. But my point is this, that come in whose shelter? Radharani. Surrender to Lord Srimati Radhika. Surrender to Lord Srimati Radhika. Because this is the land of Vraj. Where are we sitting right now? We are sitting in Vrindavan. This is Vrindavan. You are not in Narela right now, but in Vrindavan. Very beautiful this is. This mood you must keep. And I always just explain, all you eat vegetarian food. Chant holy names. People, they speak a lot. There are many speakers, but those who don't follow themselves and then they preach, then it's almost useless. That's why my point is this, that must eat pure food, nice food. That's why in the shloka it is coming. In scriptures it is mentioned, Ahar Shuddhi, Shuddha Shuddhi. Whoever purifies the food that they eat, the more and more their heart will be purified. God has created everything. Everything is to eat, right? Everything is for eat. God has created food. Everything is for eating. No. A living entity eats another living entity and then survives. This is true. A living entity is bound to eat another living entity and survive. This is true. You can see a little insect. Birds eat that insect. And who eats the bird? A cat eats the bird. And who kills the cat? A dog kills the cat. And who kills the dog? Lion. And who kills the lion? Hunter kills the lion. I'm saying this because this material world is like this. But we are humans, we have intelligence. We have discrimination power. What to eat, what not to eat. In Gita it is explained. It is forbidden to eat the food with the mood of ignorance. About three kind of food it is explained. Tamasik bhojan, rajasik bhojan and sattvik bhojan. If you eat the food of tamasik, mood of ignorance, then the heart is contaminated. Like if someone drinks alcohol, देयर लाइफ कंप्लीटली गेट्स डिस्ट्रॉयड कंप्लीटली दे देमसेल्व्स आर डिस्ट्रॉयड एंड दे आल्सो डिस्ट्रॉय देयर फैमिली मेंबर्स आल्सो
सारे पैसा को क्या करते
ऑल मनी दे वेस्ट दे डिस्ट्रॉय ऑल द मनी
अच्छा शराब पीना अच्छा है कि
इट्स गुड टू ड्रिंक अल्कोहल और नॉट
अच्छा है
गुड No, it's not good. Why you drink then? You tell me. Anybody drink cigarette? On cigarette it's right. Smoking kills. Smoking is harmful for the health. It is very very dangerous for the health body. What do I say? Even the educated people are drinking. They are smoking. It is the cause of cancer, but yet they smoke. But people still they smoke. You should not smoke either. That's why onion, garlic, all these things don't eat. This with tamasic, mood of ignorance. It all comes in tamasic. If no tamasic, then why are we not eating onion garlic on this Monday that we keep the fast? You tell to me. Oh, Navaratri. Navaratri about to come. After 2 months, Navaratri, the 9 days where people, Indian people worship demigoddess, is Navaratri. In scriptures, 9 days are kept. So the 9 days, 10 days, slowly, 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 you will give it up. That's why it is kept. Leave it or break everything. Leave it. Stop eating. This is the thing. I'm saying this first. To do bhajan, some rules and regulations must be followed. With unflinching faith, you have to do. That's why what I explained, that little child, he had so much faith. The sound came, God said, Vishnu said, look, this child has one faith. Without faith, if we do anything, we will not get anything.
And
people, there are some speakers, they preach, but they don't practice. It's useless. Their preaching is useless. That's why. What to do? Yourself, you must practice. And then, we must preach others. This is the clear instruction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. People speak many things, they sing songs of Braj, but we must follow in the life. This is the thing. Nothing else need to do in life. And chant holy names a little bit early in the morning. Chant holy names, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare
Hare. And on the throat, neck, we must wear Kanthi Mala. It's very very important. Many people say, why? What's the need? No, it's very very important. In scripture they said, Vana Tulsi Mala, it purifies the body. Even in scriptures it is written, after death, they don't go to hell, whoever is wearing Kanthi Mala. Yamaraj gave this instruction clearly. One who is wearing Tilak. Yamaraj said to all his servants, if anyone is wearing Tilak, if anyone is wearing Kanthi, don't go to them. जहाँ उन्हें भक्ति नाम गुरुद्यम विष्णु कृतवान इन भागवतम द श्लोक इज कमिंग यमा महाराज
अपने दूतों को आदेश दिया
कि दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन टू हिज ऑल सर्वेंट्स
सुनो
लिसन
जो एक बात उनके
Those who don't do pranam to God, don't like go to them and grab them. And those who are chanting holy names, don't go to them. There was a king. He was very, very cruel. He used to steal all the money of the citizens to construct this big palace. But this is Kali Yuga, people are like this. Every turn is like this. People, politicians, they come and they say, oh, we will do this, we will do that, vote for us, and when they win, they all run away, they don't fulfill their any of their promises. First they fold their hands, after elections the people fold their hands to him. They go to thousands of people and they say, Bhanji, Bhanji, oh dear sister, oh my mother, oh my brother, vote for me, please remember to me this symbol, vote here. And when they win,
then
thousands of people, they will. Let's suppose it. Some people are good. I'm not saying they're bad. Otherwise, how is the world running? How is India going? Don't think that all are the same. It's not true. There are good people also. They work selflessly. They are serving the nation.
Okay.
So that king, he was bad, cruel king. I was telling you about. Very, very cruel king. He used to steal the money of the citizens, and he created a huge palace and he enjoying sense gratification with their money. How many years passed by? 90 years passed by. King knew that after my death, these Yamdutas will take me and they will beat me very strongly. That's why the king, what did he do? At the time of death, what did the king do? He called artists and he created 100 deities just as like him. Like he cloned deities, just looking like the king exactly. The 100 statues were there and they all were covered with a piece of cloth. At the time when the time of death came, the king, he went near the 100 statues and he lied down, so everything was looking same. Now it was the time of death. Yam Maharaj, he said to Yamdutas, go grab that sinner king. Like at the time of Ajamil, Yamdutas came. How many Yamdutas came? 3. Why? When we sin, commit sins, we do 3 things: by body, by mind, and my speech. These are the 3 mediums through which we commit sinful activities. Yamdutas came and then they saw, where is the king? They saw that there were 101 kind of looking dead bodies. 100 were statues and one was a real king. So who is the real king? The Yamdutas couldn't find out. Everyone was looking the same exactly. If we don't catch the right king, then the Yam Maharaj will punish to us. The servants were thinking, because you cannot catch anyone. For this regard, he was looking who is it, and he became surprised. To Yam Maharaj, there are 101 statues there. Who is the real king? We cannot find out. Yam Maharaj came himself. Yam Maharaj, he was surprised. Oh my God, what to do? Who is the real king among them? Who is the original king? Yam Maharaj was very smart. You can cheat everyone, but you can never cheat the God of hell, Yam Maharaj. Oh, king is very smart. Yam Maharaj is thinking, he is very expert. He is trying to hide from us. He has created beautiful statues of his own. They all look exactly the same as of his body. He started to glorify. If someone glorifies someone, then their chest expands. This is like a proverb, means they feel very nice. If someone glorifies someone, it's like the chest becomes 54 inches, means it expands. Meaning they feel very nice. When if someone glorifies someone, then they feel very nice. This Prabhuji has 53 inch.
आपके साथ रहता हूँ तो 56 इंच की रहती है. आपकी छत्र छाया में है तो.
अच्छा सुनो तो.
Okay, listen to my कथा.
राजा जब महाराज बहुत प्रशंसा करते
हैं. जब महाराज started to glorify to him. And the real king was becoming happy. जब महाराज said, oh, the king, the artist who make these statues, he must be really an expert. He did it very beautiful. But look, among all, this one statue, among all of them, there is some defect. This one looks defected. Yam Maharaj is saying, one statue looks little bit defected. The king, he said, which statue is it? Which one is the problem? Yam Maharaj came and grabbed him. And he said, he was not speaking to the deity. He grabbed him and he said, let's go. Yam Maharaj beat the king so much. And then he took him. That's why you can never cheat Yam Maharaj. Where will you run? Where can you run away from? All your intelligence, everything, Yam Maharaj will defeat you anyways. So, to everyone, don't do bad things. Do bhajan of God, follow good behavior, chant holy names.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
I will tell one more katha. Now it's almost 9. We have to go also. You also have to go. And everyone will take prasad and go. Go without prasad. Our Prabhuji is very generous. Jagat Bandhu and his wife Sangeeta. What's the spiritual name? Raseshwari. Of the organizer today. Gurudev is saying that his family is very, very generous. They have arranged prasad for many, many people. That's why before going, everybody take prasad. And he was explaining why he did not accept Surpanakha. Shyam Prabhu was explaining before. God, why he did not expect Surpanakha?
Kapat.
Listen what God said. Whoever comes in front of God, God, he accepts them. But Ramchandra, he was bound with his mood of rectitude because he's Maryada Purushottam, following all rules and regulations properly. Even if someone comes with hypocrisy, duplicity, God accepts, no problem. Anyhow, just if anyone come to God, God he accepts. Lord Ramchandra, Maryada, especially Ramchandra himself, he said, look, at the time when I got married to Sita, I took a vow. I promised to her, oh my dear wife, listen. Oh, King Dashrath, all the King Dashrath, he married 360 wives. He had 360 wives, and three are the main wives: Kaushalya, Kaikeyi, and Sumitra. Kaushalya, Kaikeyi, and Sumitra, three prominent wives of King Dashrath.
किंतु भगवान रामचंद्र कह रहे हैं,
बट रामचंद्र सेड लुक ओ माय डियर वाइफ सीता, आई टेक अ वाउ इन ऑल माय लाइफ, आई विल ऑलवेज बी डिवोटेड टू ओनली वन लेडी, वन वाइफ, एनीथिंग मे हैपन, आई विल नेवर एवर गेट एनी अदर मैरिज, आई विल नेवर मैरिड अगेन. एक पत्नी पर ही टुक अ फास्ट टू जस्ट बी मैरिड वंस, दैट्स व्हाई रघुकुल रीति से दैट इज द That's why it's the like the people of Raghu dynasty, they will never break their promise, they can die. Ramchandra said to Rukmini, I cannot accept you because I have wife, I cannot accept you as my wife, and second I took a vow, I will not get married again.
छल कपड़ सी तो भक्त सब भगवान के पास आते हैं.
Everybody comes with hypocrisy to please to God. Who comes with a pure heart? Very very few.
सब छल कपड़ कर
Everybody comes with hypocrisy to please to God. Anyhow they come like this.
Our
acharyas are explaining. Those who have desired for liberation, it is also hypocrisy to please to God. It is the biggest hypocrisy to please to God. Dhamma prajita kaite vo. कम इन सिद्धांत इट्स नॉट ट्रू दैट गॉड नॉट एक्सेप्ट हिम बिकॉज सुर्पनखा वाज हिपोक्रेट टू प्लीज इट नो बिकॉज रामचंद्र वाज इन मर्यादा ही वाज फॉलोइंग रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन बट ही गॉड ही कट द नोज एंड इयर्स ऑफ सुर्पनखा व्हाई सो दैट नो वन एल्स विल एक्सेप्ट हर
सी
If I take you, how no one else will take you? Don't be offended. The beauty of ladies is in the nose and ears. Tell me, all the mothers, tell me. Don't be offended. This is true. Nose and the ears. If someone cut your nose, then you will look ugly. रामचंद्र से सुर्पनखा ओ सुर्पनखे इन रामलीला आई विल नॉट एक्सेप्ट यू बट आई हैव एक्सेप्टेड यू डायरेक्टली इन कृष्ण लीला आई विल एक्सेप्ट यू दैट सेम सुर्पनखा कुब्जा इन कृष्ण लीला सी हाउ ब्यूटीफुल दिस इज दैट्स व्हाई एनी हाउ यू कम टू गॉड एनी हाउ Hypocrisy, duplicity, anyhow, God will accept you.
और दूसरे इन्होंने अब बताया क्या?
ऐसा कि ही एक्सप्लेन्ड दैट
पुतना की जो है
पुतना
छल कपट किसे आते
पुतना की मेरे hypocrisy, duplicity, right?
भगवान उसे कौन सा गति दे दिया?
And God gave her what?
अक्तूचितो गति
He gave him the highest benefit.
Putana
did not do any bhajan sadhan.
एक तो कोई व्रत कर लेते
चलो पुतना कुड हैव डन अ फास्ट पुतना कुड हैव डन समथिंग बट पुतना डिड नथिंग नो एकादशी नो फास्ट नथिंग शी यूज्ड टू किल चिल्ड्रन पुतना यूज्ड टू किल चिल्ड्रन श्रीमद् भागवत इट इज एक्सप्लेन पुतना बाल गाते
नहीं
रुधिर आसना
खून के पीने वाले
ही ड्रिंकिंग ब्लड ऑफ लिटिल चिल्ड्रन
ऐसे पुतना के भगवान ने क्या किया
गॉड व्हाट डिड ही डू
मार करके उनको क्या दिया
ही
धातु
तो गति
तो गंगा दयालु तो पुतना के ऐसे सर्वोच्च गति कैसे दे दिया
पुतना बिकेम Why did God give the highest liberation to Putana? Even the highest and highest of devotees, they do hard austerities. Even then, they cannot attain this. Well, how did Putana attain? Beyond heaven, there is Vaikuntha. And beyond Vaikuntha? There is Ramlok. Beyond that, Dwarkapuri. Beyond that, Mathura. Beyond that, Golok. Beyond Golok, गोकुल वृंदावन
देखो उनको कहां भेज दिया पुतना को मारकर उनकी आत्मा को
गॉड किल्ड पुतना एंड पुतना अराइव्ड गोलोक द हाईएस्ट प्लेस शी बिकेम द मेड सर्वेंट ऑफ मदर यशोदा शी बिकेम द मेड सर्वेंट ऑफ मदर यशोदा दैट्स व्हाई गॉड इज सच मर्सीफुल
बोले पुतना के ऐसे गति क्यों दे दिया
भगवान? Why did God give this रत्नावली कथा योग
बलि महाराज
बनी वॉज डूइंग फायर सैक्रिफाइस
और उसके जगदस्थल में स्वयं भगवान वामन देव आ गए
फायर सैक्रिफाइस वामन देव केम केम एंड सेड
तीन पद
गिव मी थ्री स्टेप्स ऑफ लैंड
बलि महाराज ने ठीक उसी समय
At the same time, Bali Maharaj son, sorry daughter, Bali Maharaj daughter, Ratnavali. She saw the beautiful form of Vamandev and she thought, oh, very beautiful child this is. If he had been my son, then I would have breastfeed him. God, he knows everything. He knows the heart of everyone, Vamandev. Said, okay, definitely I will. Accept your breastfeed. And when Bali Maharaj, when he started to give donation, and Vamandev, what did he do? With one step he covered the whole earth. With second one he covered the whole heaven. And Vamandev Bhagavan said, Bali Maharaj, where should I keep my third step? Bali Maharaj said, I have given everything to God now, but I have not given myself. Prabhu, please be merciful and keep your third step, your beautiful lotus feet. Put it on my head. And Vamandev Maharaj, what did you do? Bali Maharaj, he sent to Sutal Lok. After seeing this, Bali Maharaj's daughter Ratnavali, she said, he's very, very bad. He showed small feet, baby feet, and now he manifested big. And he said, I will tell you, he showed us small feet, but at the time of taking, he manifested huge legs. Huge feet. See, at that time, this Ratnavali, I will breastfeed him, but I will put poison on my breast and kill to you. God said, no one can kill to me. That same Bali Maharaj's daughter, Ratnavali, she appeared as Putra. And she God delivered her and gave her the topmost position of being a maidservant of Mother Yashoda. God is so merciful. With any desire, if we go to God with hypocrisy, duplicity, anyhow, God, he accepts us. He's extremely merciful. Bhagavatam, this shloka is coming. With any desire, if you go to God, if you go close to God, God he fulfills all the desires. God he gives the deliverance, the best benefit. So we should go close to God, we should do bhajan of God. Anyhow, chant holy names.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Sankirtan Parihasam, Sobham Krinam, Devava, Vaikuntha Namam, Brahmana, Asisagaram, Vidurudhi.
Anyhow, with any desire or not, anyhow, just chant holy name once. People don't want to chant holy name in Kali Yuga, right? Forcefully they chant, slowly they will want to chant. Some bad smell is coming, then you close your nose and say Ram Ram Ram. You hear bad thing and you say Ram Ram Ram. People use it like as a slang to everything. So anyhow you chant the holy name, then God will give you the highest benefit and free you from this clutch of material existence. That's why everyone chant holy names.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.